Good evening, and thank you for joining us. It's Thursday, May 28th, and I would imagine for most of you that this is just another day on your calendar. But for the members of the Wyndham Chamber Singers, it's a date that has been scheduled for over a year. Tonight was supposed to be our annual senior concert. It's a night where we sing our tour program and give special recognition to the graduating class. Right now, the choir should be filing onto the risers to the boisterous applause of family and friends. Even though I'm standing here in an empty auditorium, I assure you that in the next hour, we will give a fitting tribute to not only the graduating class, but all of the singers who have had so much taken away from them this year. Even so, we have continued to meet as a choir, drawing strength from each other as we all work through these uncertain times. Tonight is not going to be a typical concert, and spoiler alert, it's not live. While there will be some singing, we will also look back on the past year, the past 4 years, and we will meet each member of the graduating class. When putting this together, one thing was very clear. There were many things we would not be able to do. Instead, we chose to put our emphasis on what we can do. I reached out to every member of the senior class to see if any of them might be interested in singing a solo. No pressure, completely optional, no real restrictions. To start the night off, please welcome Sophie Potter singing "God Help the Outcasts" from The Hunchback of Notre Dame.
Can hear me, or if you're even there. Next, Corinne Ulmer will sing Always Better from the Bridges of Madison County. Finally, Chloe Sear sings a solo version of Only in Sleep.
Thank you.
On this wall are the senior pictures of so many of our alumni. Students enjoy looking at these, especially seeing the different hairstyles. Very soon, we'll be adding 11 new pictures to the wall. Let's meet the graduating class of 2020.
Asia Jane Nelson. Asia would like to recognize her mom and dad for always being there for her through everything. They've pushed her to be the best version of herself and never hold back from anything that she'd set her mind to. So thank you so much for the love and support through my journey at Wyndham High School. This is Asia's first year in Chamber Singers. While at Wyndham High School, she's also been very involved in cheering and musical theater. She is a member of the Spanish Honor Society and the National Honor Society, as well as the Tri-M Music Honor Society. Her favorite memory from this year is the look on everyone's faces on the first day back from summer break. It reminded her of a huge family reunion. Everyone was hugging, talking about their summer, and just enjoying the presence of their friends. In that wonderful moment, she knew she had just been welcomed into a new loving family, and it was a day she will never forget. Next year, Asia plans to attend Southern Maine Community College on the way to getting her phlebotomist license. Eventually, she hopes to go into psychiatric mental health nursing. Asia Nelson. Willow Morales is the daughter of William and Tammy Morales. She would also like to recognize her siblings Samantha and Gabriel and her grandparents for all supporting her in the arts and everything she does. Willow has been in Chamber Singers for a year and a half. This year she served as wardrobe manager. She's had 3 years as a student class officer and 2 years of tech for the musicals. She's a member of the Tri-M Music Honor Society and has participated in the District 2 Honors Choir. Willow's favorite chamber singer memory is last year on tour when she got a whoopie pie that was as big as her head and almost ate the entire thing. Next year, Willow plans to attend Southern Maine Community College for either business or liberal arts. Willow Morales. Aiden Day is the son of Kevin and Kristen Day. He would also like to recognize his sisters Audrey and Carly, as well as his grandparents Judy and Charlie Pearl. Aiden has been in Chamber Singers for 3 years. Currently, he serves as president. He's involved in the Boy Scouts of America as an Eagle Scout and a junior assistant scoutmaster, serving the community and mentoring youth. For his Eagle Scout project, he built a picnic area along the Presumpscot River with erosion barriers at the head of a trail leading to the riverbank. Aiden has served his class as president and treasurer. He's a member of the National Honor Society and has served as secretary. He's a member of the Spanish Honor Society and has participated in varsity indoor and outdoor track. He is a scholar athlete, has served as a Boy State delegate as the legal advisor to the governor, and the recipient of the Bowdoin Book Award. Aiden has participated in the All-State Chorus, District 2 Chorus. He is a member of the Tri-M Music Honor Society. His favorite memory was performing at Notre Dame Basilica in Montreal his sophomore year. Next year, Aiden will be attending Quinnipiac University to study biomedical science on the pre-med track. Aiden Day. Angeline Gentile is the daughter of Debbie Gentile. She would also like to recognize her grandmother. Angeline's been in Chamber Singers for 3 years. Last year, she held the office of wardrobe manager. Angeline has been very involved in dance and has attended the last 2 years Portland Arts and Technology High School. In 2017 and 2019, she participated in the District 2 Honors Music Festival. Angeline has two favorite memories from Chamber Singers. The first, getting lost in Montreal, because after we found our way back to the hotel, Dr. Nick showed us local Montreal. It was my first real experience seeing a new culture, and I loved it. Also, Last year, on the last night of tour, one of her best friends in the choir bought a pint of ice cream from the lobby. They just sat in the hotel room, ate ice cream, and talked. Next year, Angela will be attending the University of Southern Maine, but is undecided on her major. She will probably do something with either dance or creative writing. Angela Gentile. Ben White is the son of Alan and Gail White. He would also like to recognize his sister, Kelsey. Ben has been in Chamber Singers for 3 years. He's also participated in soccer, tennis, the ski team, and the Roosevelt Soccer Club. Ben's favorite Chamber Singer memory was the Montreal tour, his first year in the group. Next year, Ben plans to attend the University of Maine in Orono to study engineering. Ben White. Matthew Chassie is the son of Jennifer and Adam Chassie. He'd like to recognize his little brother Nicholas and his sister Emma, who he is lucky enough to share in this group for two years. He also wants to recognize his grandparents, Memmy and P, Grammy Rock and P, Nanny, Nana Chassie, and the rest of his family, who means so much to him. Matthew was in Chamber Singers for 4 years. He participated in the fall musical all 4 years and the one-act play his junior and senior year. He was in concert choir all 4 years, and he has received the Student of the Month in Spanish his sophomore and junior year, and an Earth Science Academic Award his freshman year. He's a member of the Tri-M Music Honor Society. Matthew's favorite Chamber Singer memory was singing with Norm Lewis his senior year at AmFam and the annual fall parties to welcome the newest members of the group. Next year, Matthew plans to attend St. Joseph's College and will major in communications and business and minor in video productions. Matthew Chassie. Xavier Cummings is the son of Caleb and Kendra Cummings. He'd like to recognize all of his siblings for always being so supportive. He would also like to recognize his Grammy Elizabeth, Grandpa Earl, Grammy Robin, and Grandfather Dylan. Xavier's been in Chamber Singers for 4 years. This year he served as stage manager. He's also participated in cross country, the one act, and Science Olympiad. Xavier's a member of the Spanish Honor Society, and his senior year he was accepted into the Maine All-State Chorus. His favorite Chamber Singers memory is almost leaving David at the A&W and the Magic of Christmas. Next year, Xavier plans to attend Penn State with a major of forensics. Xavier Cummings. Chloe Sear is the daughter of Angela and Jason Sear. She also wants to recognize her sister Daphne and her brother Nolan. Chloe has been in Chamber Singers for 4 years. She's also been involved in Wyndham High School drama and the musical theater productions. She is a member of the Spanish Honor Society. She participated in the District 2 Honors Music Festival for 4 years and was a member of the Maine All-State Choir for 2 years. Chloe's favorite Chamber Singer memory is being caught dancing to Sleigh Ride on the surveillance cameras backstage during Magic of Christmas. Next year, Chloe will be attending Long Island University Post to obtain a Bachelor of Fine Arts degree in musical theater. Chloe Sear. Sophie Ray Cummings Potter is the daughter of Troy and Jennifer Potter. She'd also like to recognize her grandparents, Earl and Elizabeth Cummings, and Gary and Paula Potter, as well as her younger brother, Alexander Potter. Sophie's been in Chamber Singers for 4 years and has held the office of librarian. While at Wyndham High School, she's participated in the musical, the one-act competition, and Be the Influence. She's a member of the Spanish Honor Society, National Honor Society, the Tri-M Music Honor Society, and was a first place winner in the 2019 Wyndham Raymond Lions Club Speech Competition. Sophie also participated in the District 2 Honors Festival. Her favorite chamber singer memory is playing Egyptian Rat backstage at the Magic of Christmas. Sophie will be majoring in musical theater at Manhattanville College. Sophie Potter. Virak Trey. V writes, I would like to recognize my mom for her years of effort putting up with my many rehearsals and concerts. She's brought me many things I had forgotten at home, and I appreciate it a lot. I'd like to thank my dad for instilling tenacity and hard work into my ethics. I do not know where I would be without my parents' guidance. I would like to thank my uncle Heath McVane for getting me into music. He has been an inspiration to me, and I am thankful for him for getting me to sing with my guitar for the first time. V has been in Chamber Singers for 4 years. He's also participated in varsity soccer, varsity tennis, varsity swim team, National Honor Society, and Spanish Honor Society. His favorite Chamber Singer memory was the time on tour spent with Will and Ben, especially turning up the temperature in the room to 85 degrees. Next year, V will be attending Union College in New York. Virak Trey. Corinne Ulmer is the daughter of Malcolm and Betty Ulmer. Also, she would like to recognize her brother John and her sisters Marissa and Jocelyn. Corinne has been in Chamber Singers all 4 years and currently holds the office of assistant conductor. She has also participated in theater, the one act, and student council. Corinne is a member of the Triumph Music Honor Society, the Spanish Honor Society, and she's the recipient of the George Washington University Book Award. She's participated in the District 2 Honors Festival, and her favorite chamber singer memory was doing Magic of Christmas, December 2018. Next year, Corinne will attend Marymount Manhattan College with a major in acting and a minor in music. Corinne Ulmer.
Right now, I'm in room 306 at Wyndham High School, more commonly known as the choir room. Every Wednesday at 4 o'clock, chamber singers meet here for a grueling yet fun 3-hour rehearsal. Flags hang from the ceiling that symbolize places the choir has toured, as well as the various choirs and exchange students that we've hosted. On the far wall hang the portraits of every group dating back to the 1980s. The calendar still shows what was supposed to be the next day of school when we last left the building. The room is filled with memories. Here's a look back at some of our most recent memories.
I wish that I could only change it. Take the calendar and rearrange it. Then every day would be so nice. Candy canes and all the snow that's fallen. Every summer we'd be decked the hall. And
maybe every wish you have will turn out true.
Every day a Christmas card from me to you.
So I pray.
So I pray. Why couldn't it be Christmas every day? Riding round with Santa on his sleigh. Don't you know if you'll be good just like you should, you'll hear those jingle bells ring. Why couldn't it be Christmas every night?
Christmas
holding
every
hands beneath
night.
A twinkling light. When you say that every day's a holiday, you'll hear those carolers sing. Why couldn't it be Christmas, Christmas, Christmas every day? Just believe in Christmas, Christmas, Christmas all the way. And every time I see your eyes,
every time I see your eyes,
there's a mistletoe that's right above you, where the Christmas gifts do say I love you. Your eyes and you can almost see,
you almost
it.
See it.
All you have to do is just believe it.
Maybe there's a gift for every girl and boy.
Maybe there's a stocking full of Christmas joy. So I pray,
so I pray.
And I wait,
and I wait,
and I hope that it doesn't come late. Why couldn't it be Christmas every
you are not alone.
close my eyes and I can see a world that's waiting up for me that I call my own. Through the dark, through the door, through where no one's been before, but it feels like home.
They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say I've lost my mind. I don't care, so call me crazy. We can live in a world that we design. 'Cause every night I lie in bed,
gonna make.
There's a house we can build. Every room inside is filled with things from far away.
Ooh, special things I compile, each one there to make you smile.
And I when I grow.
Just because you find that life's not fair, it doesn't mean that you just have to grin and bear it. If you always take it on the chin and wear it, nothing will change
when I grow.
Just because I find myself in this story, it doesn't mean that everything is written for me. If I think the ending is fixed already, I might as well be saying I think that it's okay. And that's not right.
One word can kill a dream, one word can break a heart that's hiding in the shadows. When a voice is crying out, when a voice is all alone, will we turn away or listen? We can be the whole.
The history of the Wyndham Chamber Singers, every concert has started the same way, with high fives. It's our way of connecting with each other before we bring our music to life. Today, we honor the graduating class of 2020 with one final high five.
Thank you.
enjoyed this look back at our year. Congratulations to the class of 2020. You have clearly shown that you can persevere in the most challenging of circumstances. When it became apparent that we would not be returning to school, several people reached out to me just to say how important it is that we sing again. I agree. We never did get to sing our tour program, so for now, this will have to do. Thank you for joining us tonight. We hope that next year, we'll see you right here. Stay safe.